Hello and welcome, everyone out there. Thanks for joining me this evening. I'm Danny Gill. And for the next 30 minutes or so, we're going to talk about the best way that you can learn songs and how you can use what you learn from songs in your own playing. But during this session, it'll be about 30 minutes or so, kind of take it loose here. Feel free to write to me. I'd be very interested to know what songs you guys are working on, what songs you're having trouble with in particular. And so feel free, keep in touch. Let's have this be a little interactive. So feel free to write during this session here. So I'm going to talk about five areas so you can learn songs and really retain the material and use it in your own playing. So the first thing is, you want to learn songs in small sections and plan what you want to learn in each session. So you want to have a goal. That's numero uno. Number two, dos. You want to limit the amount of time you spend on a song. You don't want to spend all day working on one part of a song. After about 15 to 20 minutes, you won't remember much. Sad but true. Our brains are wired to best retain information at the start and at the end of each practice session. So if you have a lot of small practice sessions, you'll learn more than if you just try and go for 8 hours one day. So, small sessions. Okay, that was number two. That requires an E to F. I threw in a G there. Okay. Number three, and I may look off camera a little bit because I've got some notes here just behind me, behind you. So number three, I want to talk about learning songs in chunks. So for example, you can break a riff in half and play maybe the first half of a riff. Or you can play the riff once and then sit out the next round and then come in again. So this way you can try and play along with the backing track in real time or with the original song, but you don't have to stress out about trying to keep up with the entire song. Just as a quick example, let's say you're trying to learn the Immigrant Song by Zeppelin, you know, the... There's a lot of areas that can give you trouble in there, that jumping over the strings, the picking pattern. So maybe you just start by playing along with the song or along with the backing track and just let it go. And next time around, and do that a few times and then catch with the. And then you keep adding on. Then maybe you get the whole riff. But you still sit one out and then you come back in. So we'll try that together this evening as well. Things like that. Learn in small chunks. Number four, that requires a E, F, G, and A minor. Steal licks from songs. When you learn songs, you want to take that and you want to be able to apply all that effort into your own playing or into other songs. You know, if you take a lick like, you know, something Chuck Berry did, right? However many years ago. That stuff is still as cool as ever. Slash does it, Van Halen does it, everybody uses that kind of lick. And whether it came from Chuck Berry and it's in a million, it doesn't really matter. Someone might say, oh, that's kind of a Chuck Berry style, but it's all good. So you want to be able to take licks that you learn, maybe change the rhythms a little bit, maybe change the key, but morph them into your own playing. So it's not just that one song on an island somewhere, but you can use the information. And number five. Number five, try playing along with a backing track or with the original song, and this will develop your sense of timing. So you don't want to just learn the riffs, you don't want to just stare at the tablature. In fact, you want to get away from the tablature as soon as possible. It's probably better to listen, to watch if you're watching a video lesson. If your eyes are just glued on the tab all the time, it's hard to get out of that mode. So as soon as possible, try and just get away from the tab. I think that's kind of ironic because we learned so much from tab, but it's really helpful to try and just memorize without that. Okay, so let's get to it. The first step, you want to have a goal. So let's say my goal is, I'm a huge Van Halen song fan and I want to learn a Van Halen song. So I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to go to a Sam Bell lesson and let's learn a little Van Halen song. This is from Van Halen 2 called Out of Love. So let's try, see if I'm okay with the tech today. You never know. Here is a screen share. I do that. Share my screen. Hopefully that's all good. So here's Sam. Let's see what he has to say. I'm going to learn Out of Love. Start with the rhythm parts.
Okay, now it's time to take a look at the main guitar riff for Out of Love again. It goes like this.
Okay, so I can stop there and just try and pick that up. Maybe I can pick that up right away, maybe not. Let's say I don't quite know what's going on. I'm gonna let Sam start to explain now that he's demoed the riff.
This riff starts out with 7-5-7 on the A string.
Okay, now before he does that, check this out. You've got this looper down here. It says A to B or A, B looper. So I want to start right here where he's about to demonstrate. I'll start on A, and then when I think it's a good point for me to loop this, I will hit B.
And we grab the D string fifth fret straight after. So far I should have.
And then... Okay, so maybe I want to loop that.
And we grab.
So did you see what I did? I hit the A to start, the B to loop at that specific point, and then that's what's going to happen. It'll just cycle that over and over again so I don't have to hit start and stop all the time.
The D string fifth fret straight after. So far I should have. And then we grab the D string fifth fret straight after.
Okay, so you get the idea. Maybe that wasn't the smoothest place to loop, but now I can try. And he's got that bend on the D string. See where his first finger is? So I don't want to just let the note sit there like I might do if I was playing piano, but with guitar we can do these little bends. Maybe I don't even come back down. I'll just bend up. Gives it an inflection, gives it some attitude, gives it a voice. So even though it's a small piece, there's a lot you can get out of that. So I'm going to stop the loop and let's keep on rolling.
So far you should have. And then we repeat that 7-5-7 on the A. And then we play the low E string third fret. And that's the basis of the main riff, really.
Okay, so I'm going to slow loop it. All right, so if you're watching along at home, feel free to jam along with that. And notice when he does that note, that fourth note, which is the G, he's got that little bit of vibrato, a little bit of a bend. Same with that low G. And if you want to look at the picking hand, you just look down here. Hopefully I'm back from sharing my screen. Hopefully you can see me now in living color. So I've got that riff. And I could just stop there. I mean, depending on which level you're at, maybe you're having trouble getting the pitch perfect, or maybe you're having trouble with the rhythm, or maybe it's easy, but then maybe put on the original song and just play that. And that's cool. You don't have to play the solo yet. You don't have to play all the other stuff, but just cycle that, and that should feel pretty good. So you've already got a lot out of your practice session. And another thing I was talking about was how to morph riffs into your own style. So let's say you've got that could be played in a whole bunch of different ways. So I learned this Van Halen song, and I kind of want to pay homage to it. So if I put on a backing track that's in E so I can play these same notes, let's see if I can figure something out. So I'm going to go to my backing tracks here. Here's something that's a little funky. That's kind of cool. That's that Van Halen song in a totally different context, but that's the riff. What if we're playing something heavier, something more metal-like? Might require some overdrive. Okay, maybe it's time to check in with you guys, see how you're doing. Is there anything happening in the chat? Is anybody there? In the words of the Scorpions, is anybody there? Chat, there we go. Like I said, technology is sometimes not my friend. It takes me a minute to get everywhere. All right, what's up, everybody? Uh-huh. Is this the correct screen? Did I not share the correct screen when doing the Sam Bell lesson? Captain Nemo by Michael Schenker. That's an amazing one. Lots of open strings and wah-wah in that one. Seek and Destroy solo. I can't remember how that solo goes, but I would imagine it's a lot of fast pentatonic stuff. Blue on Black. Cowboy Song by Thin Lizzy, Mr. Crowley. Yeah, these are all great songs. And there's, that whole Mr. Crowley thing, that's like one of the most classic riffs that is cool to play if you can get that up to speed. But once again, it's just a blues lick that if you play super, super fast 1,000 times, you can use it in a million songs. So all this stuff is really transferable to lots of different situations. Okay, maybe let's take another one. Let's say you want to do like a bluesy song. We'll do something in the blues genre. So how about a Gary Moore song? If you guys heard Walking By Myself, I'm going to share the screen once again. We'll learn a little bit of the song, and then we'll try it along with the backing track. And for this one, it's got that so it's a different kind of rhythm. So it's another important aspect of learning songs most effectively is you have to choose a song that's on the right level for you. I mean, sometimes it's fun to just play songs, no matter how simple they are. But if you're trying to develop as a player, it might be a good idea to think about okay, here, I know this rock song and this one's gonna be a little bit above my level, but it'll be good to achieve that. Different rhythms in songs are very good for developing your style. So for example, if you want to develop that, this is like a, you know, the Satch Boogie kind of thing, this song is very good for that. This is a Gary Moore Walking By Myself. And it can be very challenging if you try and play this along with the backing track as well. So let's, I'll share the screen once again. I'll try and share the correct screen. Okay, so here's the Gary Moore songs.
Hi, I'm Richard Barrett, and we're gonna be looking at some Gary Moore tunes. First one, Walking By Myself, starts this way. This is section one. As you can see, that's the same thing twice with a pause in between. We're starting with...
Okay, I'm going to set up my looper. So I go to A right there.
The seventh fret of the low E string. Then the fifth fret of the A string, the fifth string. And the same again. Like that. Then up to an E5 or E power chord, which is A7, D9 and G9. Hit that chord and then slide it off to stop. Then simply repeat that. Now section two is a very short section, actually. It goes like this.
Okay, so before that,
the low E string, then the fifth fret of the A string, the fifth string, and the same again. Like that. Then up to an E5 or E.
Okay, so for something like this, I might slow it down, try and really get the. The notes are not that difficult, but it's the rhythm. So once I have that, let's see, I'm gonna stop the screen share. So I gotta do this. One, two, three. So that can be tricky. Maybe you have trouble doing all downstrokes. You wanna do it that way, that's cool. Or if you want an alternate pick. So these are things you have to figure out. But also that rhythm is so important to get that kind of feel. And I won't really know if I'm in the pocket for that unless I play along with the backing track. So here's the backing track. Okay, do you feel like you could play along with that comfortably? Let's try it. Let's see if we can get that swing feel in there. Feel free to play along. I'm playing quietly so you can hear the track. Can you get that? So that can be tricky. I don't know how you guys felt out there. Maybe that was easy for you, maybe not. Maybe you want to think about that as a good song to start learning because it's just a basic blues pattern. And then it gets into this rhythm, which is often way more difficult than it sounds. You know, if you watch, this is Gary Moore, but if you watch Stevie Ray Vaughan, and just the way they play these quote unquote simple rhythms, it's like they're a whole percussion section. It sounds like the drummer. They've got so much rhythm going on. So that kind of stuff is really great just to practice. And this is a good song for it. And I'm doing all downstrokes here. So if you try doing it with some ups in there, that might be a little more difficult. So all these little small things go into it. So if I play just that intro and then we'll go into the main part of the song, feel free to jam along. You know, it's gonna be from E. To A, B, and the turnaround. Everybody should be able to play a blues, but it's much more difficult than it sounds. It sounds easy, but I don't think it is so easy. One, two, three. Okay, so that was an example of just a blues tune, but let's review all these things that we've talked about. Ways to learn songs. You want to go in small sections, very important. Limit your sessions. If you pick a part you want to learn, try and do a lot of small sessions. You learn more at the beginning and at the end. So if you have a lot of 20-minute sessions, you'll learn more at the beginning and at the end. That's the information that you retain. So keep it small. You don't spend 5 hours doing that. Number three, learn in chunks. So for example, we want to take a riff, we want to play just part of a riff. So I was going to say, I said earlier I'd play a little bit with the Zeppelin idea. So if I have, here's the groove. And yeah, I don't know where you guys are at all, but I find a lot of people have trouble with this riff. If you never played it before, try it. See if you can keep it going in tempo. So instead of trying to play the whole riff, I'll just play a little piece of it. But I can start by working on my rhythm right away by getting comfortable with the backing track. That will develop my muscle memory. I'll just play a little bit. Maybe that's all I need. You get the idea. Maybe I'll add on to that. Maybe now I'm ready for the whole round, but I'll sit one out. Maybe I'll continue and give it a rest. So that was number three, learning in chunks. That's a good way to practice. Stealing licks from other songs, that's, you know, something you have to do. I mean, I can't tell you how many times I've played, something. Van Halen lick, but yeah, so everybody's gonna say that's a little bit of Van Halen, but as long as I'm not playing exactly, you know. Like that, it's quite all right. But you know, even that idea, you can take that and use that somewhere. And finally, number five was play to a backing track or with the original song so you develop your muscle memory, your sense of timing. It's all very, very important. Try and throw away the tabs as soon as you can. It's a great tool to help you get started. But you know, when you're on stage, you don't want to be looking at the tabs. And it's easy to get stuck in that mindset of having to look at the paper. It's much more freeing, and you'll be able to feel the music a lot more if you don't look at the tab. I mean, when you watch guys that are really into it, you know, they're smiling or they're closing their eyes or something. If you look at someone who's just reading the page, it's not quite as emotional. So I guess that's it for this little short lesson. I will say thank you all very much for hanging in there with me. I probably had some technical glitches, but I'll figure it out for next time. Always learning, just like guitar. Enjoy the ride. It's all good. So thanks again. I hope I see you guys all again soon, virtually. Feel free to keep in touch with Lick Library, with me, with Stuart. I will say a big thank you to Stu Shields for helping out with all of these webcasts and everything. So that's me signing off. Thank you very much. Have a great rest of your evening.